Music has a lot of characteristics, and one common characteristic is tension and release. There are a few common things that you could do to build tension. One is repetition. When you repeat something over and 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 over, you get the idea. Use technical terms like ostinatos or loops or something like that, but everything just boils down to a lot of repetition. Examples include build-ups in dance music. Or in those dramatic percussion pieces you hear in movie and video game scores these days. Or something as simple as the blues. Something really pedantic. And something even profound. I'm gonna say the same thing. That's the second time, the second round. Repetition comes in all sizes. Shoot, Slayer made an entire career out of it. Another thing that can help is rising pitches. Listen to any EDM track or any movie score over the past 10 years or something like that. There's always some kind of rising pitch. There's always some kind of string cluster or brass cluster or some kind of rising tone of some kind. You're never without it. Another one is dissonance. Dissonance is the beating in between two tones that don't really agree with each other. I'm sure you can look it up on YouTube and find somebody explaining it really clearly, but that's basically what it is. And remember those tone clusters I was saying? That's all that they are. It's just all the tones just kind of crunched together going... You hear it in every single horror movie. Here, this is what it sounds like. Another way to really rack up tension is to hold something back. Whether this be a certain pitch or a rhythm or something or whatever, if you could hold something back until it's awesome zenith, sweet. Look up Ligeti, cello concerto, Lux Aeterna. He does this in quite a few things where he does a huge tone cluster for a long time but keeps one or two notes away so that once those notes are hit, and speaking of release, all you need to do to create some release is just change something. Change the entire way that the piece is going, change a chord, change the key, change something, just change something. Boom, release. Even if it goes to another tense part, even if it goes to a completely different part, even if it goes to a completely different song or something, even if it only lasts for a tiny fraction of a second, any change is going to bring about a little bit of release. Maybe unless you're doing minimalist music, but then again, that's a really different way of thinking about music. What about, like, relaxing meditation-style music that sounds like there's no kind of tension in it? There's still tension in it. There may be more release than tension, but there's still tension in it. It may just be released for a long time, and then all of a sudden, a little bit of tension, and again, I put a list of songs and pieces I really like in the description, just in case you want to do some more studying on tension and release. But really, just listen for it in everything. What else could cause tension and release in music? Let me know, because I would love to steal your ideas.